what I was thinking on stage at the concert. Dark coming in, but still suffused in light under a burst of elms. We're in mid-set, a summer concert series on the lawn in front of the John Brown House. People ease in folding chairs or picnic on the grass. Good listeners, they know the protocol. Applaud our solos if we've pushed ourselves. Kids under 12 have come in free. A group of little ones who may not know of jazz or what to call the thing they're moving to twirl in the open space before the stage. Like white caps, they allow the wave of sound to bear them up so we can see precisely what we're doing to their souls. No one knows how to say what jazz is well enough. To me, it's just a way of meeting life with life, exulting in a purer echo. A man approaches from the right, behind a camera, casually dressed, but it is warm and he could easily be an amateur. Moves closer to the corner of the stage. I see him framing, and I frame his shot. The alto player in mid-solo, low sunlight reflecting off his horn, presents a classic pattern in three-quarter profile. And at that angle, I am just beyond the fingers flashing on the pads, the pressed eyelids that show the player deep inside his mood, but hide his thinking all the same. I know my look as well. I'm beaming from the spell of his invention, bouncing with the beat that carries us ahead, alive with momentary grace and joy. And since I solo next, I'm listening and looking at every chorus end for signs that he is winding up. I see that in the shot I am too close behind and to the right, whether it's meant to be of him or me or both of us together. I'm a clot that spoils the composition. In a move which to the several hundred others watching will likely go unnoticed, I slip left 8 inches, curl my shoulder, go on beaming. The man behind the camera clicks and smiles.